try is there for Dunski. What a start by South Africa. Jeff Wilson. Spectacular charge down against the run of play. He's missed it. The All Blacks survive.
They wrote a best-selling book, made a blockbuster movie called The Power of One. Based it in South Africa, where power and glory and fight counts for everything. Where World Cup trophies are polished, prized, preserved and revered. World power, though, and history shows this, is difficult to retain. Especially in this old game and against these All Blacks with their names already etched on the Bledisloe. South Africa versus New Zealand. The powerful and the glorious. The official world champions against the team widely regarded as the best in the world. This is the best of the best. The Wallabies watch and wait. The world wonders as the power comes down to one.
Yes, welcome to Seven's live telecast from Eden Park in Auckland. It's the New Zealand All Blacks taking on the South African Springboks. It's the 50th Test match held in Auckland, the 48th at Eden Park, and a grand occasion, these two sides meeting also for the 49th time. New Zealand ahead now by 23 wins to 22. But looking at the Tri Nations table, we see that the All Blacks are unbeaten, Australia getting a bonus point with their win last weekend at Suncorp, and South Africa winless after losing to both Australia and New Zealand. Well, joining me in expert commentary will be Simon Poitevin and Chris Handy. Welcome, guys. Simon, what about the changes to the South African side? Is it going to bolster them?
Totally necessary, and that will help them today. Henry Honeyball in the centres will tighten up the defence. James Small in the wing, very fiery and sometimes can go off. Dalton and Herder in the front row. Dalton is also another player who can really lift the Springboks. So I think they're very important changes.
Well, let's check out the centre bet odds at the moment. And we see New Zealand are at prohibitive odds. 7-1 on and 15.5 point start. A lot of South Africans have taken that start, I might add, Chris Handy. But what about New Zealand Herald this morning? There was an article stating that the only South African who'd have a chance of making the All Black side is Os Durant. That's red rag to the bull, isn't it?
Oh, it is, and if there's no other motivation for the Springboks, it would be that. They were able to climb out from under it in Johannesburg, and they're capable of doing it. They're away from home, they haven't done so well away from home. They're a bit like the Mummies boys, you know, they're a bit uncomfortable when they get away from the base. But I think there's everything to prove today, and they'll be at it. If we get something like we did 3 weeks ago, what a great game it'll be.
What a tough venue, though, for South Africa, Eden Park, one of your favourite grounds.
Oh, yeah, well, you know, my first test match there, but the crowd there, very good crowd, and they'll appreciate this game.
OK, well, the South Africans surprised everyone by delaying their arrival in Auckland. They got there only on the Thursday, so 48 hours before the game. At the final press conference yesterday, we heard from the two skippers.
We're pretty confident. We learned a lot from playing them at Ellis Park as a team. And whether we play at Eden Park or Ellis Park, I think we're in with a shout. We've just got to put it together. We can't afford to make mistakes, especially against the All Blacks. And I think against Australia, we made far too many mistakes. And we couldn't get any continuity going. Whereas, you know, at Ellis Park, we had a lot of continuity going, got our forwards into the game.
We're not looking at what happened at Suncourt Stadium. We're looking at what happened at Ellis Park, especially in that first 20 minutes. And I think the games that we've had against the Springboks, we've got a lot of memories of some very physical and hard games.
We're going to run out, and we need a win. So we're going to put a lot into it, and you know, we might be, I think we're out the Tri Nations now, but in terms of team building and we need a win.
So I thought they scrummaged very well against Australians. They definitely had the Australians in trouble on Saturday night, and I think they're only strengthening the team with Herter coming back in, and with Dalton going in also. So yeah, we're going to have our work cut out there. But that's good. That's, you know, we seem to perform to our best when we've got a challenge in front of us.
Yes, Simon, Derek Bevan, the referee, the ageing Derek Bevan, is he up to it today?
Well, he's certainly not lacking in experience. World Cup Final 91 did an outstanding job that day. And as long as he talks the players out there, that's what the Southern Hemisphere referees do so well. The North's got to learn that.
Chris, what does South Africa have to do here?
South Africa have got to massage the All Black front row. They've got to be able to take them on at their strength and get on top of them. Otherwise, all the rest will just be fairy tale stuff.
Well, it's Sean Fitzpatrick's 50th test as captain of the All Blacks. Lots of milestones today at Eden Park. We'll be back with more after the break. Yes, what a beautiful day it is in Auckland, the city of sails, and also host for the 1999 America's Cup. New Zealand, the defending nation. The big crowd rolling in at Eden Park. 45,000 people is the capacity there. A lovely playing surface. So we really are set for a fast open spectacle. Sean Fitzpatrick, his 50th match as the All Black skipper this afternoon, Simon. He certainly is a man who's going to lead by example. Tyshman has to do the same.
Yeah, Sean Fitzpatrick, a lot of Auckland players in the All Black side as well. So they love playing at home and a fast pitch. So expect a lot of points here today.
They're looking very fresh, these New Zealanders, Chris. Obviously, they're very keyed up. They really have to start explosively after South Africa did 3 weeks ago.
Yeah, I think that's the motivation. Fitzy's 50th test as captain at home. They really treat moments like that very specially, and they'll go off.
Well, they are two great sides. Let's now line them up head-to-head. New Zealand now leads South Africa by 23 test wins to 22. Two fullbacks line up, it's Wellington's Christian Cullen and Russell Bennett from Border. On the right wing, brilliant Jeff Wilson opposes speedy Andre Snyman. At outside centre, veteran Frank Bunce and Percy Montgomery. At inside centre, Alama Iremia from Wellington and recalled Henry Honeyball. On the left wing, exciting Tana Umanga is back and he opposes James Small. The two number 10s are Carlos Spencer from Auckland and Yanni De Beer from Free State. The scrum halves, a mighty clash, Justin Marshall and Joost van der Westhuizen. At number 8, the Auckland skipper, Zinzan Broek, and South African captain, Gary Tyshman. The open side flankers, Josh Kronfeld, Otago, and Andre Fenter. At blind side, Tane Randall, also Otago, and the aggressive Ruben Kruger. The second row, number 5, Robin Brook and Mark Andrews. And number 4, Ian Jones, his 65th cap against Prano Otto. At tight head, Olo Brown, his 45th international against Marius Herter. Sean Fitzpatrick, the All Black hooker, his 90th test match against James Dalton. And at loose head, Craig Dowd from Auckland against the Ox, Oz Durant. Yes, well, we're seeing some pretty spectacular build-up at Eden Park, Auckland at the moment. And it's a mass gathering, and certainly the New Zealand public has responded to this Auckland team. They've been beautifully marketed, Simon. They've won 15 out of 16 under John Hart, and really, they seem to be a cut above everyone else.
And they'll be really trying to target Yanni De Beer today. His defence last week against Australia was really abysmal.
Yes, what about Henry Honeyball coming back in, Chris?
He's a very strong defender, Gordon. I think it's his best position.
Okay. Well, the two coaches, John Hart has 6 out of 6 this year. Carl Du Plessis has 2 out of 6. Let's hear from them.
South Africa, you know, obviously were hurting from the loss at Ellis Park. They're a tremendously strong side. I think they've got a lot right now, and we expect a massive encounter against them, and if it's as good as the Ellis Park match, it's going to be a great game.
Yes, certainly it's often very important to us. You know, we've missed the win at Ellis Park with 3 points. We would like to set the score straight. New Zealand has always been our arch rivals in the rugby field. That's going to be a tough contest, a big challenge. But the team is looking forward to that. We've got a very good mix of experienced players and also a few young blokes in there. and I'm sure that they're really ready for this opportunity of taking the New Zealand.
Yes, and don't forget Seven's match of the day in AFL, Hawthorn and the West Coast. Please check your local guides for transmission details. But we're building up to New Zealand versus South Africa here at Eden Park. 45,000 fans in. It's a beautiful day. And after the break, we'll be meeting the man who rejected a $2 million offer to turn to rugby league after the World Cup in 95. Back shortly. She's a man. She's a man. Yes, will we see a repeat of that epic clash just 3 weeks ago at Ellis Park between South Africa and New Zealand? 35-32 to the All Blacks. It's a lovely day at Auckland. Very little wind, really, which is very good news, but a nice firm surface. Well, as I mentioned, one of the Springbok players rejected a $2 million offer to turn to rugby league after the 1995 World Cup. When he played his first game in a Springbok jumper in 1993, he scored 4 tries against Western Australia. Let's meet him now.
South Africa are the world champions of rugby.
The team with the biggest discipline. I mean, the guys stick together and concentrate, and it's worth it.
Since that Ellis Park epic, the Springboks have met New Zealand 6 times for just 1 win. The slide in fortunes for South Africa has also coincided with the dethroning of Joost van der Westhuizen as the premier scrum half in international rugby. At 26, the Northern Transvaal number 9 is a marked man.
When I started playing, I set myself a standard, and I think that standard has dropped, because the opposing teams didn't know me at all, and now they know me, and yeah, I think definitely I'm a marked man, and they keep my space down, and that's why I'm at the moment only a link, just waiting for the gaps to open.
Australians first recognised the potential of van der Westhuizen on the Springbok Tour in 1993. He finished leading try scorer with 11 spectacular touchdowns. An international star was born. Joost scored a critical try against the Lions at Ellis Park last month. After losing that series, the third test victory signalled a change in fortune. The Boks' ensuing clash with New Zealand at the same ground was a corker. The home team running in 2 brilliant first half tries.
The try is there for Joost. Here they go. Van der Westhuizen, what a pass! Russell Bennett somehow held onto a bullet pass. And the Boks get their second.
But ahead 23-7, things went horribly wrong for Joost and the Springboks.
Jeff Wilson! Spectacular chance down against the run of play.
Wilson's try turned the game, and fingers were pointed at the Springbok number 9.
I've scored a few tries kicking the ball over and scoring my own. Even the New Zealander said Wilson was offside, and I don't care. It's just the execution of the whole kick that was wrong, and I'll do it again.
In a few minutes, van der Westhuizen lines up against classy Justin Marshall from New Zealand. So where does the Kiwi rate in the world scrum half pecking order?
I'll rate him maybe 3rd, just because nobody saw him behind a losing pack. I mean, the All Blacks' pack was always up front, and he's playing behind a winning pack, and I've seen George Gregan play behind a few losing packs, and he did well. He can still control the game. I think that's why my personal opinion is that I rate him as the best scrum half at the moment, because he's playing excellent rugby, and as I said, I just want to see Justin Marshall behind a losing pack.
David behind a winning pack last weekend, Gregan was man of peak as he worked his magic with David Knox and Ben Tune. The result was a nightmare for the Boks, but they're ready this time.
I said it last week, Australia, they were down and they came back, and they smell the win again, and I think they'll be up there again.
Yes, Simon, he is a great player. He hasn't played to his potential, but what about his combination with Yanni De Beer? How crucial?
Well, that's going to be really whether the Springboks win the game out of that combination. But the other thing is that an important point he made, the Springbok forward pack must be going ahead. If it is, you'll see him having a lot of opportunities out there, and he takes those opportunities.
Crucial clashes from the forward point
of view?
Well,
surprise, the front row, Osterlund and Ollo Brown. If Ollo Brown can subdue him, Australia has still got some problems next week. But for the box, Teichmann's their key man.
Simon and Chris, let's now have a look at the overall record between New Zealand and South Africa. This is the 49th test, and since the South Africans came back in 1992 from isolation, they've only won two matches against the All Blacks. So New Zealand has really turned it round. They lead by 23-22. Can the Springboks turn the tables this afternoon? We'll know very shortly as we join play after the break. Building up to this test match, the 49th between New Zealand and South Africa from Eaton Park, Auckland. The crowd is in and already up around the 45,000 mark. A bit of breeze has sprung up over the last half hour, but as you can see, the ground is in superb condition. There's Derek Bevan on the right, our referee, the man who was in charge of the 1991 World Cup final, and he'll be assisted by Glenn Wallstrom, who is the reserve touch judge. He'll be assisted by Joel Dumay and also Clayton Thomas. So it really is a great scene here, Simon and Chris. The crowd expecting another All Black victory, but the South Africans really hurting, and I think this is the match ball arriving.
Well, the huge job ahead for the South Africans is a lot of these players during the Super 12 played at Eden Park and had really big defeats. Psychologically, they've got to lift themselves to this game and prepare themselves for a All Black onslaught.
Chocker block the ground. What a fabulous sight, and every reason to applaud this great side of theirs at the moment. All the colours out, all the passion of All Black rugby.
Is that the Wellington Hurricanes colours there, I think?
I think that's the Bull Allen alter ego.
And also Tana Umanga is back into this New Zealand side, also one of the stars of the Wellington side, leading try scorer for them in his first three seasons. He's been a magnificent player. Well, New Zealand and South Africa played the 300th test match for New Zealand last year at Lancaster Park, and Andrew Merton's goal kicking was the difference in that Tri-Nations game. But Simon and Chris, we would have to say that New Zealand has the upper hand, and South African rugby at the moment in turmoil. They've won only 2 from 6. There's a threat of a judicial inquiry into South African rugby, the running of the game over there. Their under 21 team bombed out. They've lost the Tri-Nations. They've also lost the series against the Lions. It's a huge task for them this afternoon. Can they do it?
Well, it is, and they tend to dig deep when adversity hits, so I don't think we take any notice of the form last week against Australia at Suncorp. They'll lift themselves this game, and I expect that Ruben Kruger in particular will need to be the player to spark their resurgence.
What a pressure on Carol Duplessis, the rookie coach, and you've got to call him rookie. He's got to take this side through. A great result in Johannesburg, but you know, they don't last too long over there, it seems, since World Cup times coaches.
Well, just watching the All Black reserves, Mark Bull Allen, Norm Hewitt warming up, and Charles Rickelman also there, and Scott McLeod from the Waikato Chiefs has come in. Lee Stensis appears to be out of favour. His defence probably let him down a little bit at Ellis Park 3 weeks ago, so Scott McLeod has come in, and he's a very decisive player. But last year, the All Blacks made a clean sweep of Tri-Nations. They beat the South Africans also in the series over there on South African soil for the first time in history. And when the New Zealand side came back from South Africa, 100,000 fans lined Queen Street in Auckland to welcome home their heroes. Now Gary Teichmann, the celebrated Springbok number 8, his 21st international, Oz Durant and James Dalton into the side there with Marius Huerta. Well, you can see the focus tonight. If there was some passion and intensity missing against the Wallabies at Suncorp, it will be there this afternoon at Eaton Park. Here they go. Eaton Park, Auckland, was the venue for the inaugural World Cup final back in 1987. As we look at this South African lineup, two backline changes and also two in the pack from the side that went down to the Wallabies last weekend. Some badly needed experience added to the back line. James Small and Henry Honeyball return, while scrum power and aggression added to the front row with the recall of Mario Serta and also James Dalton. So it's a beefed up forward pack, and Henry Honeyball, the playmaker, fine tackler, a man who really, I feel, has been missed in this South African back line. And Tyshman, well, certainly only two wins from six. He has to answer his critics, as does this man, the scrum half, Joost van der Westhuizen.
Van der Westhuizen in this game has got to get these forwards going forward like he did in that first 20 minutes 3 weeks ago at Ellis Park. The Springbok forwards then were just unbelievably strong and had the All Blacks backpedaling.
So here comes Sean Fitzpatrick now, leading out the All Blacks for the 50th time in a test match. Frank Bunce will lead the team out in his 50th international for New Zealand. He made his debut back in 1992 as a 30-year-old. And what a fine moment for Frank Bunce.
Frank Bunce, great favourite, really muscled it out in the back line for the All Blacks. Tough, but also very skillful, and he'll be focused today.
Frank Bunce, one of 18 New Zealand players to score test tries this year. Looking at their side, the All Blacks have made just one change to the team that downed the Wallabies at the MCG. Dreadlock winger Tana Umanga returns from his shoulder and sternum injuries. Veteran centre Frank Bunce chalking up that half century. And the forward pack sets a new world record, a total of 352 test matches in this starting eight. What a magnificent performance, and the tight five unchanged over the last two seasons.
And this guy, Sean Fitzpatrick, 90 test matches now. It's easier for backs to get up the test matches out there, and we've seen David Campese and Philip Sellar do it, but for 90 test matches in that front row, a huge achievement. And this man, Zinzan Brook, another key player for the All Blacks, has been for the last 3 years.
Yes, well, he's played his 53rd test match. And now this teenage schoolgirl from Auckland to sing the national anthems. Outstanding rendition from 13-year-old schoolgirl Adriana de Kyrish.
Oh!
the celebrated Dame Kiri Takanawa sang World and Union at the 1991 World Cup, will young Adriana rise to those heights in 2003? There's the reserve bench for both sides. Joe Gillingham from the Gauteng Lions has come into the Springbok camp, and Scott McLeod for New Zealand. So Zinzan Brook to lead the haka. Haka perform with dynamism and precision as well, and the Springboks, Chris, electing not to face it.
Good, and yes, they concentrated themselves, and again Zimzan Brook not jumping traditionally at the end of the haka. That groin he's looking after.
So here's our referee today, Derek Bevan. He was the only World Cup referee to receive a gold watch from Louis Leite in 1995. It wasn't solid gold, he said. It was only gold-plated. That was after South Africa down France in the semi-final, Simon.
And what a game that was. Murray's Herder back into the side for this game, and this man is the key.
James Dalton also getting a welcome recall from the Gauteng Lions, just 24 years of age. He set up that famous try for Peter Hendricks in the World Cup opener in 95 at Newlands. Here we go. The 49th test match between New Zealand running from the left and the Springboks. South Africa humiliated last weekend by the Wallabies at Suncorp. Van der Westhuizen. And an early offside there by Josh Kronfeld.
Well, a little bit of a feint there by Van der Westhuizen. Caught Josh Kronfeld. Kronfeld explosive off the mark. And that time caught out. Bevan right on top of it.
Teichman talking about no mistakes for his team. And that is a very significant factor. They sustained unbelievable concentration in Johannesburg. And must do the same.
So Derek Bevan, our Welsh referee, who had the 91 World Cup final, has refereed the All Blacks 12 times. And they've lost five of those. James Dalton. Very good attacking platform here for South Africa. Teichman. Big drive on. It's only 15 metres out. Osterratz. What a start here by the Springboks. They're very close. They're over. James Dalton, I think, has scored the try. We'll wait. It is Ruben Kruger. Ruben Kruger gets the first try for South Africa. What a start.
And are we in for another feast of great rugby? Are we ever? This is great work from the Springboks, and the one thing that will fire the game up. They've driven as Australia did in the opening moments at the Melbourne Cricket Ground, but they retain possession and advance the ball. The great Dos Durant, the even better Ruben Kruger.
Well, the key to the success of this try was the fact they split the line out. They didn't have the All Blacks there in numbers to stop the drive. Durant is huge, but this guy, Ruben Kruger, very strong, played a big game at Ellis Park. He's back.
Yes, well, he's had a very quiet international series, Ruben Kruger, formerly from Free State, now Northern Transvaal. The kick was successful, so a seven-point advantage to South Africa. That's Iremia picking up the crumbs. Marshall now. Spencer quickly to Butts. Great pass to Wilson. Tries on here. Fullback Cullen. Did he get it? Lost the head.
Well, the ball came in there, was knocked down by a Springbok defender. Wasn't really required. The All Black player was in front, would have been a forward pass. This pass back inside. As we see Christian Cullen in support. And the ball goes astray.
Here we go, Chris, with this big scrum battle.
This is so important. All of a sudden, they've gone from the sublime to the ridiculous. They're right on their own line, and this must hold up. All Blacks have the chance to really put some pressure on.
Well controlled by Tyson at the back. Yari De Beer almost charged down by Spencer. So we're still inside the quarter. South Africa ahead 7-0.
The last matchup, these two sides, they use Zinzanbrook and Tane Randell particularly well. Here we see Zinzanbrook standing at halfback. They use him to sweep round the back of the line out.
Tane Randell at the front. Now New Zealand apply South Africa with their own medicine. Craig Dowd, Tyson the tackler, assisted by Fenta. Spencer! Iramia very hard to stop. 7 metres out. Quick ball. Marshall. Dat Olo Brown. Ian Jones is there. South Africa hold on. Cullen's in. Christian Cullen. Did he get there? Not quite. Offside. Well, New Zealand probably wanted a bit of advantage as the temperature boils over. The aggressive James Dalton in the thick of things.
Well, surprise, surprise, it was Henry Honeyball who let the All Blacks slip through to surge away towards the line as Derek Bevan caught them offside.
This cocky little Welshman is a good referee and he's not going to let it slip away. It was a great plunge by the All Blacks. It got so close.
Would you want some advantage there, though, Chris?
You'd think you would.
So Christian Cullen up into first receiver, Simon. Score here is 7-0.
Heartbeats home on 7.
I'm beginning to feel like I'm part of something here.
Starring Nick Berry and a great cast of colourful village characters.
Into uniform, there's work to be done.
7.30 tonight, 7 puts the heartbeat back into Saturday nights.
So we're back with the 21-year-old from Auckland, Carlos Spencer.
Look at that fantastic crowd. The terraces are packed here at Eden Park.
This one really point-blank range for Spencer on his home turf. Not a problem for the youngster. So the difference is 4 instead of possibly being all square. 7-3 South Africa.
352 tests between this All Black combination. Wonderful balance and composure they have to fall back on.
Yanni De Beer then with the restarts. Certainly looks as though it could be one of those pulsating days if the early moments are any indication. Marshall. Fenta coming through. Umanga. Andre Fenta wrapped him up and tries to turn him. Marshall again. Spencer steps. Dalton the tackler with Teichmann. About 15 metres from halfway. Craig Dowd getting very involved. One off the ruck. They're working it in close. That's Robin Brook. 9 from halfway. Ian Jones goes in. Good clean out. Marshall probes. There were some offsides. The referee calls it back for a penalty. US Van der Vest Hazen thought he was away.
Well, the opportunist. Just went from the Vestasen. And it was too big an opportunity, not one that he could refuse. He wasn't in the right position to take it. How often we've seen him break a game up before and he's looking for a big one.
Wasn't a bad bet by Van der Vestasen. If the ball had gone wide, certainly the All Blacks had the numbers.
So 15 and a half point start given to the Springboks. And Carlos Spencer has gained about 3 metres. That's some sort of record, I think, for New Zealand from a kick for touch, but it also gives an indication of the breeze, which has picked up.
There's some reason to suggest in general play, but
Ian Jones at the back. Cronfeld straight through the middle. Bit of variation there from New Zealand halfway. Tane Randall. Teichmann getting through some good defensive work.
David in!
And this time, the team in possession is penalised. Players not staying on their feet. Robin Brook, the offender.
And that's the sort of penalty that Peter Marshall, I doubt, would have given at Ellis Park. The players are playing positive rugby. They're trying to get that ball out quickly. And you are coming in with momentum. Junior Tanu on the sideline there. Here we watch Tane Randell goes to the ground here. The drive comes in. Robin Brooks, the man who's principally in trouble this particular time.
So good, clear, decisive decision-making from referee Derek Bevan. Very experienced, Tane Randell. Prino Otto jumping in the middle. Up he goes. Intercept. Kruger looking for number two. Tasman couldn't hold on. Knock on.
Whoa. Nearly again, and this time he was onside. In general play, following the ball, and Reuben Kruger nearly had the ability. I've lost the line out, and he's just following through. Tyshman, unlucky, came off his chest.
Interesting there that Tyshman was interfered with after he lost the ball ahead. The All Blacks took him out, so he had no chance of regathering, and he didn't have possession of the ball. But it all happened very quickly. South Africa 7-3.
Kruger's done himself a bit of damage here. He's hurt his knee. I would have thought he could have got to the line himself.
Looks like a serious injury, Simon, as you say. The silent assassin, Reuben Kruger. Fritz van Heerden, ready to come on here, Chris.
This is a crucial injury, and it looked badly like ankle, knee area. He got side on, and his foot buckled underneath him. And Fritz van Heerden wouldn't be assuming he'd come on this early in the game, and this could be a turning point.
Well, certainly a worry for the Springboks, because Kruger's reasonably mobile out there, and you've got a very mobile All Black back three.
So great concern here in the Springbok camp, and it certainly looks curtains for Reuben Kruger, Karel Duplessis. So the score here, South Africa 7, New Zealand 3. So that really is a crippling blow. Fritz van Heerden is onto the field here at Eden Park, and the Pretoria potato agent, Reuben Kruger, will be taking no further part in the game. And he looked as though he was in outstanding form.
Yeah, he certainly was fired up for the game. It reminded me a little bit of when Tim Horan did his knee in the Super 10 final a few years back. The change of direction, momentum of the body going one way and the knee caught going the other.
Still being placed on the stretcher here. Fritz van Heerden did not play in Super 12. And that's a very sorry sight for this outstanding blindside flanker, South Africa's Player of the Year back in 1995. We've had 9 minutes of play, and South Africa ahead by 7-3.
Good to see the use of the All Black camp's medical personnel in there, and as we watch it, oh, watch that ankle go over. Oh, terrible.
It's like a racehorse that's broken down mid-stride. It's that ugly sight of the foot twisted out of shape because the ankle's just given up the ghost.
So certainly, barring that mishap, Kruger almost undoubtedly would have got the try. And a good clearing kick here from Marshall. That's a fine clearance up to the 10-metre line. Justin Marshall having the beautiful platform provided by this crack All Black pack. Ian Jones jumping at two. Robin Brooks moved towards the back, just in front of his brother, Zinzan.
Hey, people, free kick!
Here we go, Hunter Vesthuizen. Nice offload there to Tyshman. Springbok skipper did well. Hunter Vesthuizen working that short side. Galton now. South Africa looking for their third straight ruck win. Here it is. They're on the quarter. Yanni De Beer back to Tyshman. Ian Jones the tackler. Osdurant slipped it back. De Beer, honey ball. Cut out now for Russell Bennett. Look at that defense. Oh, a big clean out too from Mark Andrews. Hunter Vesthuizen. That's the quarter line. Andrews doing well in the early stages, but again, players diving over the top. Well, we saw some crunching midfield defence there from New Zealand.
I think, I don't know, referees should have a bit of a go at driving into some of these rucks and mauls themselves, and sometimes you just cannot stay on your feet. The players aren't trying to kill the ball.
Well, particularly when Mark Andrews comes across and gives you one under the short ribs.
There's Frank Bunce in his 50th international, having led out the All Blacks this afternoon. So it's been very, very physical. Tana Umanga over the top. Yes, there he is, Tana Umanga, the 24-year-old from Wellington. Ian Jones beautifully to Zintan Brook. Good tackle there by Fenta. Breakdown arrives. So does Brown. Marshall to Spencer. Bunce. He's a handful. Montgomery couldn't put him to ground. Great run by Bunce. Iramia. Alama Iramia. Poor defence there by New Zealand. No nonsense. Palm off by Frank Bunce.
Well, Frank Bunce, the nightmare for the Springboks emerges again. And this was very ordinary defence from Percy Montgomery. Just pushed away by that Bunce strength. In came Bennett, but Iramia skipping past James Dalton.
It'll say Iramia on the scoreboard, but this is the man that made it. The ball in the right hand, bending with the left. Changes it to the left hand and bends with the right. Picks up the defensive player because he stayed on his feet. You wouldn't want a better outside centre than this.
So bad missed tackles there by South Africa. Firstly, Percy Montgomery, and then fullback Russell Bennett. And the All Blacks give the impression now they really want to take control of this game. This would put New Zealand to double figures. Well, he really hooked that one. Let off there for the Springboks.
It's a guy like Danny Herber, who is the great Springbok centre, must look at this defence and just shake his head. You just can't give the All Black attack this sort of latitude.
Iramia getting his second test try. His other was against Japan. Snyman couldn't take it. Cronfeld did. And Gary Tyshman into touch.
And this is the difference that Justin Marshall has over most of the other halfbacks at this level. He's got a wonderful kicking game and he can drop into if it's the right option. New Zealand having no trouble retaining their own line-out ball.
Just a point in it. Ian Jones again to Robin Brook. 10-metre line, South African territory, down. Straight into Fenta. New Zealand edging ahead and controlling possession here. Sean Fitzpatrick, that right knee heavily strapped. Ollie Brown. Craigged out again. Just running at those inside backs. Spencer. That's Brook. Fenta the tackler. South Africa. May have spoiled. Henry Honeyball. Christian Cullen. Crowd urging him to have a go. South Africa can here. Snyman set it up for Dalton. Tyshman Great counter here from the Springboks. Mark Andrews arrives and smuggles it back now.
Up you get. No, come to get more.
So a scrum feed here for South Africa.
Excellent counter-attack there from the Springboks. Eventually got bogged down in the heavy All Black traffic. And the Springboks unable to get this ball out. Andrews working feverishly to get it out.
When I say head, you head. That's that offensive tackling that the All Blacks are so renowned for, their upper body strength, being able to roll the player as they tackle them.
Good.
Fairly close. Average forward weight with the big Fritzman hitting him.
Yes, and the front row crumbling that time. Great pressure from New Zealand scrum, but a good reply here from Yanni De Beer. Christian Cullen again. Happy to keep the ball in play. This is fullback Bennett. Springbok forwards arrive. And now a penalty against Bennett for not releasing the ball. Again, the referee blowing very quickly. Fitzpatrick into Dalton. Edging up to the 10-meter line. Marshall. Zinzanbrook, big tackle by Osdorant. Here comes Eremia. Fullback Bennett is there. And so is Van der Westhuizen.
Interesting so far in this game. James Small with the ball now. I've seen nothing of him. He'd just be itching to get into some sort of action.
Well, it's obvious that the All Blacks have picked out County De Beer as the place to attack. They're really heading up for him. And it was only Osterunt that came across to do his tackling for him. And I think you'll see a bit more of it in the first half. The All Blacks really hitting it up close in.
Well, that is great offensive defence from Osdorant. Springboks need more of that inspiration. Van der Westhuizen. Yanni De Beer. Steering that one up the touchline. Umanga. Cullen. Halfway line. Montgomery misses another tackle. Cullen with electric pace. Spencer, a flick pass. Honeyball won it. South Africa back in possession, then lost ahead.
Forward in the tackle.
Looks like a Springbok feed.
Forward in the
tackle. Well, Percy Montgomery, he's got to pick his game up. Otherwise, there's going to be a cricket score out here. Christian Cullen, one of the good attackers in world rugby. Look at that pass back from Spencer.
Tighter scrum this time from the box. Yanni De Beer just evading Josh Kronfeld. 10-meter line now, New Zealand territory. The All Blacks ahead 8-7. A try to Iramia. A penalty to Carlos Spencer.
The Springbok defence in the backs have forgotten the basics about tackling low. They've been suckered into it and got fended off, just swatted like flies.
We've heard that Ruben Kruger has dislocated his ankle. So we're past the quarter stage of the game. Robin Brook at the front. Zinzanbrook. Dalton coming in to spoil. That's Sean Fitzpatrick. Murray is hurt at the tackler. Spencer again. Iramia. Good tackle by Honeyball. Olo Brown there very quickly. Here they go on the short side through Zinzanbrook. Good defense from Van Heeren. Spencer. Varying his options. Bennett didn't go into touch. Crowd thought he did. Van der Westhuizen now. Chance to swing it wide here. Montgomery around Bunce. Oh! Snyman went the wrong way. So Montgomery caused problems for Frank Bunce at Ellis Park. But he'd rather forget that pass, I think.
Excellent pass from De Beer. Long one. Gives Montgomery room. The switch back inside was on, but not read by James Small.
And James Small still not seeing any of the ball.
Good pass to Umanga. Really hitting the advantage line. And they've turned it over, New Zealand. Great clearance from Teichmann. Snyman. And We're back into New Zealand territory. Uncharacteristic mistake there by the All Blacks.
Well, the Springboks using that tactic, forgetting one thing, they haven't got John Eales out there. John Eales won 5 lineouts against the Springboks last week. And I don't think the Springboks have a player who can do that in their lineout.
So Andre Snyman making a good sortie that time from the right wing. Well taken there by Ian Jones. He was coming down that time. Recovered very well. 9 from halfway. Ferocious defence in the game so far. Butts. Better tackle that time from Montgomery. Yanni De Beer up quickly. Cullen now. Van der Westhuizen got in. That's good defence from the box again. New Zealand recover. Spencer goes wide. Big hit, but great hands from Zinzan Brook. Randall, Fitzpatrick and Wilson. Snyman across. Oh, Fitzy. Give him an Oscar.
Come on. The New Zealand limp falling champion. He would certainly make it into the final. He may not win. It was good work to shuffle the ball. They knew that they had some numbers out wide. But Wilson, as he's normally able to get on the outside, Fitzy came into support, then just tries to keep it away from the box.
Jeff Wilson with a great strike rate, 21 tries in his 30 test matches. That was Otto. And Westhuizen. Players just getting through the line at that time, forcing the mistake. South Africa, just as they may have retained possession though. Teichmann goes in. 8 play 7. A lot of talking going out there from the Kiwis. Some of it directed at referee Bevan. Snyman's kick's gone straight up. Was he taken out in midair? I think he was. Henry Honeyball penalised.
But you've got to hold off on the man.
When a man's up in midair, it's regarded as a dangerous tackle. You can't take his feet out like that.
That's a clear example of why it's dangerous. You're just not in control. Ian Jones so good in the air, and then he's gathered up and turned over. Ugly side.
Multi-skilled, this All Black forward pack. Ian Jones, Inzam Brook, Robin Brook all over the field. Sean Fitzpatrick, that pass out wide.
Well, if there was passion lacking in the Springboks play last week, it's certainly there here today. 8-7 New Zealand.
I remember a time when a young person could get a wonderful snack anytime for under $3.
Yeah, the good old days.
No, yesterday. You coming?
McDonald's $2.95 McValue snack.
So we're about 42 metres out from goal here for Carlos Spencer. He's missed with his second attempt after getting his first. And that one hit the post. It's with that familiar tattoo. This one to take New Zealand to double figures. He's much happier. The crowd saw it early. Second penalty goal for Carlos Spencer. And New Zealand by 4.
Carlos Spencer's had plenty of ball to use this game to date. He's had 9 possessions, he's passed it 8 times and kicked it once, whereas Yanni De Beer has had 7 possessions, passing 3 and kicking 4.
Beautifully dealt down there to Zinzan Brook. So South Africa through fullback Bennett. Delayed his option, then lost ahead. Knock
two
on knock both
on,
ways.
First by Green.
So nearly 28 minutes gone in this first half. It's 1 try apiece, but Spencer's goal kicking the difference. New Zealand running into what is described as a light breeze in this first half. Cullen, beautifully tackled by Van der Westhuizen. Teichmann, he wants the bounce. He got it. Gary run. And it came from the scrum half. What a tackle by Vonder Westhuizen. What an inspiration for South Africa.
This man is the key. He's the captain. He's also their best athlete. It was great work here by Vonder Westhuizen. Dynamic ball provider, then Teichmann. He is just like a greyhound. Slightly built, but very, very quick. Great try.
Gary Teichmann couldn't have asked for a better bounce, but the tackle from Van Westhuizen takes Cullen to ground, and what's the footwork here? Now what's the bounce of the ball? Hits, comes straight back into his arms, and just sprints down this sideline. Didn't need the support, gets it himself. Was that divine intervention? Gary Teichmann, this great Springbok number eight, who's really led his troops today from the front. And a crucial score for South Africa.
It's a bit like don't worry about shutting the gate. The horse has already bolted. Gary Teichmann was away and aided by that beautiful bounce.
That's a fine kick by Yanni de Veer. So the Springboks consolidating back in the lead. Remember that New Zealand has lost just the one test match here over the last 11 years, and that was to the French in that magnificent spectacle back in 1994. It really is a favorite hunting ground for the All Blacks. Mark Andrews. Springboks have their tails up now. Two tries to one. Vonder Westhuizen drives it deep. Christian Kallan. That kick has come off the side of his boot. There's a chance here for the box. Dalton. Kallan through with the tackle. Good composure there from the hooker. Vonder Westhuizen. Yanni de Beer. In behind the back line.
Now you can't tell me Tane Randell was onside during that last ruck. Slipped in behind the referee, was way up ahead of him.
I think with quality possession like they just had, Springboks need to keep taking this game to the All Blacks. The soft option of going up the line only gives the All Blacks possession back and allows them just to slow it down and to balance and regroup.
Punt hidden. That's the quarter line ahead. Yanni de Beer, nice little pass there to Honeyball, who stood his ground. Percy Montgomery, nasty bounce here. It's a try, Montgomery. Christian Cullen made a mess of that one, and he's gone from villain to hero. The youngster, Percy Montgomery.
Just when you'd be saying, don't kick it away, particularly when you're in your opposition's quarter zone. Skews off the boot, it definitely wasn't meant to go that way. But it turned out a gem.
The hard work in this try was done by Henry Honeyball. He took that ball up, hit some very big All Black defence. The ball came back for the Springboks, and Percy Montgomery, who's had a very ordinary game to date, scores a very important try.
Well, he's saying, what about that kick, the banana kick? Luck's a fortune for South Africa. Two bounces from heaven, really. No blame on Christian Cullen, not much he could do about that. And South Africa have stunned this big crowd at Eden Park. Yanni de Beer on target, three tries to one. And the Springboks out to a very handsome lead, 10 points. Remember, they led 23-7 at Ellis Park 3 weeks ago and lost the game.
Percy just settling it down. I'm sure it's still very clear in their memory, that loss.
Excellent take by Cranel Otto. Van Westhuizen clears to De Beer.
So we're inside the quarter. And this is Christian Cullen. And the chases are good too. Henry Honeyball was up there.
Black, Honey, black.
Quick throw in. Under Vesthuizen with pace. Forwards arrive. Dalton clears. De Beer. Tyshman recovered. That's Cullen. This is Iremia. Mistake by South Africa. They could be punished. Marshall wants it. Fitzpatrick got it back. Confeld. Cullen. Wilson. Umaga. Spencer. What a reply from the All Blacks.
Mistakes by any side against the All Blacks will invariably be punished. And this one was a classic. The ball movement by the All Blacks got past the Springbok defence, and eventually the defence ran out of numbers and Carlos Spencer strolls the corner.
So Carlos Spencer gets his fourth test try.
Saw in the Johannesburg test a mistake by Van der Vesthuizen cost them close to half time, and this again allows the All Blacks to claw back.
Yes, well, it was Wilson and then Spencer at Ellis Park who got those two tries in 2 minutes in that first half. So New Zealand with this great ability to hit back in the championship period. South Africa humming, 10 points ahead. But it's been whittled down to just 5. John Hart, well might he scratch his head. The bounce of the ball has been cruel for New Zealand, but they create their own luck. The linchpin of the Auckland Blues backline has pushed it wide. Score 21-16. New Zealand trail by 5. So they're the men in the tight forward pack for New Zealand. The boiler workers. Good anticipation there from Randall. Spencer. Big Kanana kick straight through to fullback Bennett. Confeld the tackler. And players diving over the top.
Leave it! Number 8, stay your feet, you're diving in.
Zinzan Brook, the man penalized.
Well, pretty clear instructions there from Derek Bevan. Springboks a little bit lucky. The ball was caught the wrong side. Now it's just about 5 minutes before half time. Look at the position. As Bennett takes the ball forward, in comes the tackle. Zinzan Brook fell on the ball there, so fair penalty.
So the quarter line away to the left. Penalties evenly distributed. And allowing for injuries, we have about 6.5 to go. That's Andrews. Ozdurat gets right underneath him. Otto is there with Dalton. So too is Fenta, number 7. Hunter Vesthuizen. Honeyball. Sneyman. South Africa set up well in midfield. Drop goals on for De Beer. He's got the distance, but just out to the left. Christian Cullen. We saw him kick 2 at Ellis Park to break New Zealand's hearts, but he also missed the last penalty that would have drawn the game, Yanni De Beer, in the dying seconds.
Loves a drop goal, Richie Cunningham.
Drop out from Fenter to take it. Under Vesthuizen. Not a great kick. Justin Marshall, he's opposite. Wants the bounce. And this is Russell Bennett. Adventurous play. Opening up the angle. 32 metres out.
And again we see the halfbacks kick and get them into all sorts of trouble. Van der Vesthuizen. We'll watch that short kicking game.
Good to see James Moore getting a touch. Jones did it beautifully. Randall. Overlap. Cullen. Try. Well, they've scored two tries in 3.5 minutes. They got 2-2 at Ellis Park. And the All Blacks have repeated the medicine here at Eaton Park.
Well, the All Blacks put a lot of thought into this try. Played a three-man line-out. Had plenty of runners out wide, including Tane Randell. And Christian Cullen was given plenty of room to score a try. The three-man line-out is the key.
It happened just as though you would do it in training. Perfect position, beautiful line, great time pass. Cullen the finisher.
Well, what a thrilling test match we're witnessing here at Eden Park. And what a strike rate for Christian Cullen. 17th test match. And that is his 16th try. Scores are level here. 21 apiece. This to put the All Blacks in front for the second time. They don't come much better from touch. So the lead has changed four times in this match. Tane Randell with the final pass.
Just so many runners out there, the All Blacks. Hard to organise a defence against that number of options.
Well, the ball was cleared into space very quickly. There was a triple cutout pass there. That's Robin Brook. James Dalton has a sniff. Again. Butts. Cullen. His pace is electrifying. Great tackle there from Bennett. Van der Westhuizen. Taken out by Kronfeld. Dalton. Chance for a counter. Was that man onside, Spencer?
What fantastic work by used Van der Westhuizen there. Stayed on his feet, got the ball back. Bunce gives Christian Cullen the run. Bennett comes in with a tackle, takes him to ground. Now watch Van der Westhuizen. Stays on his feet, steals the ball.
Well, I think South Africa would love to get this half-time up. Trailing by just two. New Zealand threatening again. Yanni to be the tackler on Iramia. Marshall. Back to Spencer. Bunts now. Good tackle by Van Heerden. 35 metres out. Marshall goes wide to Cullen, who's been very involved. Umanga. Osterhout couldn't put him to ground. Randall to Wilson. Quarter line. Randall. Kronfeld. They're keeping it alive. Back for Dowd. Olo Brown. Dalton the tackler. Ian Jones is there. And again, the referee lets it go on quickly. No advantage there. Butts couldn't hold on. Was there offside?
Well, Justin Marshall will make Derek Bevan play advantage here. Derek Bevan, why didn't let that ball go? I don't know.
Well, it's all got to be a penalty try then, hasn't it? He's ruled them offside. The try was going to be scored. No doubt about that. South Africa was on the rack.
Just these subtle ways that refereeing decisions can affect the flow of a great game. Need to be quick. All Blacks just pounding the line. Umanga carrying it up, and Randell just, he's really grown in stature match by match and deserves the rap that John Hart gives him. Dowd joining in, and they just slowly but surely advance it. Prop after prop. And the ball in here goes out of Bunce's arms. An opportunity gone begging.
Well, referee Bevan has ruled that the South African midfield defence was okay. They forced the error. So he's taken it back for the penalty, but certainly a penalty try decision was on there. That's a lucky let off for the Springboks. Shadows of half time. Crowd is pretty happy, but no joy. The great escape.
Loves a rumble, Frank Bunce.
He called the mark.
He's called the mark. I'll go to the referee, Gordon Bray. What do you say about that?
On the whistle.
Yeah, well, I think if he called the mark, that's fine. No worries. Here's Percy Montgomery. No banana kicks here, Percy. What's happening? Fitzpatrick came up. The mark hadn't been taken. It's half time. Pandemonium here. The Springboks out of jail. And it's been a thrilling first half. New Zealand twice coming from behind. They lead by two. We'll be back with more after the break. Yes, well, here it is. Percy Montgomery gets a fortuitous bounce. Christian Cullen can't quite get there. And the Springboks were out to a 21-11 lead. But you can't rest on your laurels against these All Blacks. They bounce back and they lead by 23-21 at halftime. Six tries scored in the game, 44 points. What about that, Simon Poitevin?
Well, certainly a wake-up call for both sides out there. And this luck has been running with the Springboks. The All Blacks, much more the surgical strikes. And the fly halves had plenty of ball to use out there. And certainly Carlos Spencer throwing plenty of passes. And the line-out going very well for the Springboks. They've pinched one of the All Black throws.
Yes, well, those IBM stats, Chris Handy, tell the story, don't they? But South Africa, they've backed themselves today, haven't they?
They have. They're really having a go, Gordon. The All Blacks, they were hitting up close into the rucks, and until such time as they do that, they're not spreading it wide.
OK, here's now your chance to win a beautiful Ford motor car. Watch closely.
The Ford Famous Try Competition is your chance to win this magnificent, fully appointed Ford Fairmont Kia, the luxurious expression of the new face of Ford, just by telling us which of the following tries you think is Gordon Bray's Ford Famous Try. Is it Try A, Jonah Lomu, applying the Maori sidestep against England in the 95 World Cup?
Over the top, Try Time New Zealand.
Is it Try B, Matt Burke's solo effort against New Zealand in last year's Bledisloe Cup?
It's got to be a try! Sensational efforts!
Is it Try C, the try from the end of the world that sank the All Blacks at Eden Park in 94?
What a try! One of the all-time...
Is it Try D, Gareth Edwards at the Arms Park in 73 for the Barbarians? Is it Try E? The maestro David Campisi sets up Tim Horan for what was the try of the 91 Rugby World Cup. All you have to do is ring the 0055 number associated with the try you think is Gordon Bray's Ford Famous Try for your chance to go into the draw for this magnificent Ford Fairmont gear.
Yes, and don't forget our AFL match of the day, Hawthorn and West Coast. Check your local guides. But it's 23-21 to New Zealand. Players back on the field after the break. Yes, well, there's the All Black coach, John Hartz. His team hasn't lost a test this year. Six out of six, but they're certainly under threat here at Eden Park. 23-21 at halftime. Springboks led 21-11. Six tries scored. Frank Bunce there in his 50th international for New Zealand. It really was a very exciting, enthralling first half. Chris Handy and Simon Poitevin.
Good, and I think John Hart will be looking for a bit more commitment from the All Black tight five. They haven't really been in the game. I think you'll see a little bit more action from them in the second half.
Possession, yes. Possession and territory, 50-50 at half-time, so really mirroring that score.
Well, when the two sides played here in 1981 during that strife-torn anti-apartheid tour, a light aircraft dropped four flower bombs on the field. One which hit Gary Knight the All Black type head prop. There have been plenty of fireworks, but more in terms of handling and passing skills, and also some deft kicks today. Here's Tana Umanga. And that's a magnificent hit early on from the box. That's been a feature of their play today. They've taken no prisoners in defence. That's the hallmark of their game, their physicality. And New Zealand certainly know they've been in the match here at Eden Park.
Umanga's really trying to get the All Blacks on the right platform. He nearly got cut in half.
Andre Fenter, the open side flanker. What a tackle.
Make sure you're five.
Fenter had a very quiet game against the Wallabies last weekend. Much better today.
Well, that's a free kick against Ian Jones. You can't jump before the ball's thrown in. Hunter Vesthuizen. Back to Teichmann. He's had a great game. Good clean out here. Fenter. Hurt is there. Hunter Vesthuizen now for his back line on the short side. That's Neiman.
It's amazing. You wouldn't know James Small's out this game. First half, got the ball once.
Clever play there from the box, using that short side where they're very strong.
So Sean Fitzpatrick in his 90th test match. Ian Jones. Fenter takes him to ground. Marshall. Wilson chases. Sneeman. Cronfeld the tackler, 10 metre line, New Zealand territory. De Beer. Henry Honeyball. Coolhead. Not a great kick though. Cullen. Bit of space. Dalton the tackler. Cleverly worked there by Butts. Siramia. Breakdown into James Dalton, who tries to rip it off him. Dowd with just too much strength that time. Jeremia. Henry Honeyball. Well, they milked the penalty that time. A bit of reaction from the crowd might have helped the referee's decision, but he ran into a brick wall of South African defenders. And we haven't taken the kick Jeff yet. Wilson in pain.
I think he might have got a help from his touch judge that time as well, because he didn't have his arm out for advantage, and then all of a sudden he gave the penalty.
So New Zealand ahead by 23-21. So big concern here in the New Zealand camp. Scott McLeod looks as though he may come on for his fifth test match for New Zealand. Tall, upright, incisive centre. But Jeff Wilson, who left the field at Ellis Park, or I should say at the MCG, when he received an ear injury, didn't take part in the second half. Cashmore came on. John Hart's pretty concerned. We're going to take the kick while Wilson has treatment. We've seen some erratic goal kicking from Carlos Spencer. Is he back on target? It's bounced over off the crossbar. Talk about fortuitous bounces here today.
You just watch it. Up, 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 and over.
So the margin out to 5 points. That's a good strike there by New Zealand. Yanni De Beer. You're watching live coverage from Eden Park, Auckland. South Africa running from the left-hand side. Only 5 minutes gone, second half. Three tries apiece. That's a clever kick. Sneeman took it courageously. Umanga, the tackler. Robin Brooke is there. Van der Vesthuizen. De Beer. And again, not a great kick. It's Randall to Brooke. Cullen. Bit of space. Referee says play on. Counter here from South Africa. Butts the tackler. 12 from halfway. New Zealand force a turnover. Here's a chance. Umanga. Quarter line ahead. Cullen goes in to lend assistance. So is Ian Jones. Cullen at scrum half. Since Zanbrook. Fitzpatrick doing plenty of talking to the referee, who plays advantage. Opening up a bit of space here for Bunce. Tiesman the tackler. Looks like a penalty. Offside play. Again, it's out in front of the sticks.
Well, Springbok defence paranoid against this All Black attack. Coming in waves is Fitzpatrick opposite the goal. Referee, helped by his touch judges, picks up that offside.
Lovely ball laid back by Zinzan Brook. Just when you need him to settle you down and get you over the advantage line, he'll do it and provide that money ball.
Clear offside there against South Africa. Deep breaths for Derek Bevan. 33rd international this afternoon for the Welshman. This could be up to an 8-point advantage for New Zealand after they led by 2 at half-time. 2 penalty goals. 2 infringements by the box. This will give Spencer 5 from 8. And it's an 8-point lead for the All Blacks. Spencer gets his 4th penalty. He also has a conversion. And 1 try. So that's 19 points for Carlos Spencer.
Springboks need to hit back here quickly. The All Blacks certainly would have the fitness advantage over the Springboks.
Now a chance for Honeyball and Dalton, taken from behind by Brook. Van der Vesthuizen recovered well. Tiesman, a good pass. Andrews. Fitzpatrick. Well, there's been some rucking here against Sean Fitzpatrick.
He's someone off here.
Mark Andrews giving Fitzy a bit of a curry as well. What's happening? Red card. I think he's been sent off. Andre Benta. Sean Fitzpatrick was lying on the ground. Frustration from South Africa, and Benta departs.
Great vision here. And that heel coming right down on the face of Sean Fitzpatrick. This is called a stomp. Not near the ball, it's at the side, and he got cleaned up.
Fitzpatrick was going in with his hands there at the ball on the ground.
Well, Fitzpatrick was in a position where he couldn't get free. Springbok forwards coming over in numbers, and Fenta, who hasn't got a bad name out there as being a dirty player, gets his marching orders.
Yes, well, that will be a case for the judiciary and the video replay. He was sitting on 2 yellow cards before this game. So the Springboks are man down now. It's all or nothing. And they've lost one of their best, Andre Venter, for stomping on Sean Fitzpatrick. Andrews also is pretty fired up. Mark Andrews really having a go, and I think number 7, Josh Kronfeld's been hurt there.
Well, Josh Kronfeld hit by Andrews with a missile. Legal play right in the middle of the mall.
You wonder whether it's about legal play or not. This is where it's a lot of damage.
29-21 to New Zealand.
In the mall with shoulders.
Yeah.
Without.
So it looks as though Fritz van Heerden's being called out. Tiesman and Fitzpatrick having some pretty stern words here, but Josh Kronfeld was pinned on the mall there. It was a very unsavoury tackle. Touch judge suggesting there was no arms in the tackle, just a shoulder charge on the pinned man. And Charles Rickerman warming up.
Looked like Mark Andrews was the player responsible. Haven't had a replay yet to pick it up. But he's been really putting into these rucks and mauls all through the game.
Yeah, I think he should use his effort constructively, not destructively he's been doing. He's a bit bitter and twisted, Mark Andrews, because his form hasn't been up there this year. And I think it's a cheap shot. He's done it three or four times during the game.
Well, he'll get his comeuppance. If he's not careful, 22-metre line, Carlos Spencer. And the All Blacks just maintaining their composure. The Springboks pretty desperate here. They're losing a bit of their cool. 8 points the difference. 11-5 to New Zealand in that penalty count. Here's Frank Butts. He regrouped so well, but he's been dispossessed. Otto at scrum half. Van der Vesthuizen, kick charge down. Brook. It's gone too far. And it will be back to the 22. Well, the South African backs haven't offered anything at all, kick so far. They won't chance their arm against this New Zealand back line.
I never thought I'd see the day of Yanni De Beer ripping the ball off Frank Bunce. That did it very skillfully then.
But then why kick the ball away? It's hard enough to win. And the All Blacks will punish you, you know, in normal times, let alone when you kick it to them, and even then not well.
They kick so much possession away, South Africa, which has made their task all the more difficult. Gone back to their old-fashioned ways here.
Well, they were so successful in that first half at Ellis Park, Johannesburg, as on New Zealand side, get a big advantage in the lineouts by running the ball wide.
So there's Andre Snyman. Hasn't seen a lot of possession on the left wing.
Big Olo Brown. Robin Brook.
New Zealand just shading in possession and all even in territory in this match so far. We've had 52 minutes of play. Tane Randall, nicely supported. New Zealand ahead by 29 to 21. They have an extra man, remember. Penta sent off. Spencer. Intercepted. Yanni De Beer again against Iremia. South African forwards arrived there. Honey ball. And that's come off the side of his boots.
29-21. Springbok back line have got to ask themselves, what are we doing belting this ball away?
I think it's a cop-out. It's a frustration. Just not confident in their attack. And it's the kick and hope. Carol Duplessis, the coach, obviously concerned,
probably saying a few prayers at the moment. It's been grueling stuff. It's been brutal. All Blacks ahead 29-21. Montgomery and Snyman standing out wide. Tane Randall, man being treated in the line out here, a little bit of blood then it looks like. Ian Jones at the back to Cronfeld. Dalton the tackler. Dalton's done some good filtering. He's done it again. Big critical turnover there. Honeyball. Ball in hand is needed now. And control. Looks like some offside play.
Opting to go for the kick the line. Gives them a chance to get down the field. And have to work their way through that All Black traffic. Penalties running 11-6 in favour of New Zealand. And coach John Hart would be disgusted with the amount of turnovers today by the All Blacks. Highly unusual.
I think it's those fine points that really irk John Hart.
Well, James Dalton to throw into this line-out. He's certainly made a difference around the field today. De Beer. Honeyball, straight into Sinzanbrook. They were waiting for him. Under Vestheisen again. Teichmann. That's Montgomery. Chase here from Small. Dalton did brilliantly and lost it then. Here's Wilson. This is Butts. Oh, big hits. Cronfeld. Montgomery the tackler. wasn't held. He was entitled to get back to his feet. Osterud picked it up. It was still in the ruck. He wasn't bound.
Very clear direction there from the referee. Get round and come back in as the All Blacks play on.
Great tackle by Tyshman on Brook. Craig Dowd to Herta. They try to turn him. Spencer goes wide to Butts and Iramia. Great passing and handling skills from the All Blacks in support. Butts now caught by Durant, the Ox. 37 metres out. Marshall. Cullen joins the line. South Africa defending manfully here. Van Heerden goes in. How long can they do it? Numbers on the right. Umanga. They've turned him in the tackle. But New Zealand still have it. Olo Brown just settling things down. Herta over the top. Marshall. Spencer. Looking for the inside pass. Now Cullen. The juggernaut goes ahead. Craig Dowd. 15 metres from the goal line. Wide ball needed. Butts to Cullen. Tyshman the tackler. Great work from a supporter there in Fitzpatrick. Marshall. Cronfeld. Spencer was wanting it. Cronfeld! Josh Cronfeld cut down by Thunder Vesthazen. Marshall. Olo Brown. Marshall! That will break South African hearts. Magnificent build-up. Superb support play from the All Blacks back and forward. And the dam finally cracks.
The All Black hammer unrelenting. Some excellent tackles by the Springboks, but eventually they ran out of numbers. Ball retention to key. Randell gets the ball back to Bunce. Bunce swivels round. Watch Durant make a big tackle here in a sec. As Cronfeld gets past, Butterbest Hazen takes him to ground, and eventually Marshall gets through with a bit of help from Olo Brown.
This is why this All Black combination is such a good team. From any position on the field, they can launch a counter. They plugged away with various players until they found this juggernaut in over Justin Marshall.
So the kick successful, and the All Blacks out to a 13-point lead. 36 plays, 21. So that is a new record score for New Zealand against South Africa. A new record score. The highest score ever against the Springboks in a test match. 36 plays, 21. There's Charles Rickelman on the field, playing in his fourth international. And Zinzan Brook with a head wound. Well, that's the killer blow coming up to the three-quarter mark of this pulsating test match. So it may require stitches there for Zinzan Brook, but if it's a blood bend, he could be back on the field. He looks pretty keen to get back out there, Simon.
Well, Zinzan, you just can't keep him down. Certainly close to the most competitive player in world rugby.
Justin Marshall works the scrum. Four tries to three. 23-21 at half time. Van der Vesthazen. But the ball lost ahead.
Good pressure applied on the scrum with one man short. Put the pressure right on the back and played Van der Vesthazen into the game.
Van der Vesthazen's had a mighty game here today. He's made a couple of mistakes, but he's been everywhere. His defense has been cracking. One of those tackles forcing a try against the All Blacks.
Narka Drotsky on the field for the Springboks. Playing at flank.
Well, he is a former flanker, Narka Drotsky. He played a flanker for South African schools. That's Van Heerden is still there. Remember that Andre Fenta sent off, so there's been a reshuffle to get some pace into the back row for South Africa. Van der Vesthazen, De Beer, Honeyball, Montgomery, stood in the tackle. Robin Brook, the tackler. 10 from halfway. Van der Vesteisen, the beer. Teichmann. Dalton's out. Good work by James Dalton. Gets underneath Ole Brown and down. Van der Vesteisen again to the beer. Tane Randall, the tackler. Halfway line. Away to the left. And New Zealand killing the ball. Here's Van der Vesteisen. He's dangerous. Looking to offload. That's Mark Andrews. Quarter line ahead. South Africa has to hit back here with a try. James Small. He's gone into his own man there. The ball was passed to James Small. And then he drove into his own man, placing him accidentally offside. Frustration.
Gary Teichmann trying to drag just the last bit of pride out of this rearranged side of his.
Marshall, just out from his quarter. Jeremia needs support. Marshall sees a gap. Andrews from behind. Cullen, he's there. Christian Cullen!
Come here.
Justin Marshall found a big hole and the All Blacks kick clear.
Well, punish and punish again. The ball turns over. This pass to Christian Cullen, a little suspicious. Justin Marshall makes the bust. Now watch this one. Spencer from that angle, hard to see, but Cullen let loose.
Wouldn't you like 17 tries from 17 tests? There's a nice ring to it. In this play, they've caught them napping. The burst, it was so straight. All players really keeping the ball straight, and this is a bloke in open play.
Watch James Small here, goes for a trip, and we think he's got a yellow card from that. The crowd booing after seeing it on the big screen. So, the Springboks looking very much a beaten side now. It's not only a record score against them, but it ends any hope they have of winning the Tri-Nations. Score here, 43 plays 21.
Cullen threw some pretty ordinary defence there for the Springboks.
So now Chiani De Beer with the restarts. 22-point leads. Robin Brook back to Dowd. Springboks playing for pride now, but they're facing a heavy defeat here. Christian Cullen. Sloppy pass from Jones. Wilson. And he lost the ball ahead. But the referee has spotted an earlier infringement.
Well, it's an interesting game where you see Jeff Wilson not having a big effect, such as it's been played. He just can't seem to get into clear space.
So the Springboks have taken Snyman off, Bodrotsky on.
Yanni De Beers off the field as well. So maybe Joe Gillingham is on. Snyman's still on the field. He's gone to centre, outside centre. Honeyball's come in to fly half. That's significant. So let's see if the South Africans get a little bit of direction in their backs now.
Marius Herter on this side of the scrum, playing without a flank and doing very well.
Great bust here by Snyman, who's into the centres now. Outside Honeyball. Van der Vesteisen. Ole Brown waiting for him. Narkodrotsky in the scrum half. Montgomery. No way through. Drotsky there. They edge ahead by metres. Tana Umanga and Cullen. South Africa now through Montgomery and Russell Bennett. Nice step. Oh, Montgomery had held onto that, he was away. And a knock on.
Forward, yeah,
had one major problem of getting away, and that was Zinzan Brook. Hit him midships.
Nice to see he's still smiling after that one.
Crouch. And hit.
So New Zealand really wanting to move this ball to the expanses now. And stretch the undermanned New Zealand pack. Tana Umanga. Big step, big palm. Bennett in the last line. Ian Jones was first man there. Marshall. Cullen looking for a hat-trick. Sean Fitzpatrick with great skills. And then down in support. Well, they've mastered the finer points of the game, New Zealand. Look at the switch to Cronfeld. He went without it.
Gone forward there.
John Hart was looking for more commitment from the tight five, and they've not let him down. Really been plundering at centre field, trying to commit that South African defence so they'll find gaps out wide. And Tana Umanga heads back at the angle and just gets collared by a very committed but very stretched defence.
Up you get.
Well, the All Blacks showing why they are the best side in the world. With this performance here today,
keep your hand off the floor.
Clinically putting the
hand
South Africans the away in this second term. Carl Duplessis, the Springbok coach, facing his fifth loss from seven test matches.
That was my fault.
Now, you won't often hear the referee saying that. It was my fault.
So, the big All Black scrum forces a tight head. Zinzan Brook to Randall. Tane Randall, the 22-year-old skipper of the Otago Highlanders, gets his second test try. And the All Blacks are in uncharted territory here with this score.
Oh, great shot here. The All Black scrum, at the best of times, hard to hold. But with seven men for the Springboks, they've just rumbled through them. Zinzan Brook picks up. And Tane Randall slips through.
This is how you expose a team that's one short. They got the push on and kept the concentration. Classic pushover try stuff. Not pushover try, but tight head stuff.
Eight-man shunt there from the All Blacks. Zinzan Brook showing his great skills. And simple in the end for Tane Randall. Sean Fitzpatrick in the hands of Dr. John Mayhew. But for the first time in history, South Africa will have 50 points scored against them in a test match if Spencer is successful here. He got it, 50 up for New Zealand. 29-point lead. So the Wallabies have to front up to this All Black team next week as Andrew Mertens is on the field. South Africa is out of the Tri Nations. Australia with the only side of having a chance of beating New Zealand now in this Tri Nation series. Gary Tyson has tried very hard. But things have gone against the South Africans in this second term. They've conceded penalties. They've infringed, they've had a man sent off, Andre Fenter, in the early stages for stomping on Sean Fitzpatrick.
Okay, I put one off. It won't stop there if it's gotta be. Hit!
So Justin Marshall and his Canterbury teammate Andrew Mertens into fly half. Nice quick hands to Iremia. Here comes Wilson. Almost. Little rub in the head from James Small.
Good play from the All Blacks. They just pushed the ball up. They've got the numbers and they've got Wilson on the wing. He's very good in the air.
A few smiles out there, but still there's a lot of hard stuff going on the forwards. Sean Fitzpatrick with both nostrils stuffed with cotton wool to stop the bleeding.
So James Dalton. Just over 10 minutes remaining in this second half. Andrews did very well. Good aggressive jump from him. Honeyball. Really taking the ball up to the defensive line. Haven't seen that today from South Africa.
Hand off it!
Well, given the state of exhaustion of the Springbok side, sensible move here. Drive it upfield from Honeyball. And then work off the line out. This ball will invariably go to either Teichman or Andrews. Fantastic jump here by Andrews. Gets through, sets the ball back.
Attacking line out then for the Springboks. Fitzpatrick drives his side on. Andrews almost pinched by Brook, who lost a hit. Honeyball, he needs support. 8 meters out from the goal line. That's Peter Rousseau on the field. Andrews in his pocket. Van der Westhuizen, Osdu runs here. Well, that's a very technical ruling there by Derek Bevan. He nudged into his man in front as he was trying to run round him. And that's refereeing to the letter of the law.
Well, Osdu Runt, he's about a meter wide, so it's a bit hard to sort of carve a slim path through it.
Here's Justin Marshall. Since Sandbrook working it off the scrum base. Nice little off-break there. 10-metre line.
Well, that's where Gary Tyson got the off-break for his first half try.
Marshall works on his kicking game to the exception of a lot of other things. He's got a wonderfully strong kick.
Plays 21. Fritz van Heerden. Marco Drotsky goes in. Henry Honeyball. Nice switch to Montgomery. He opens it up. Marco Drotsky. Van der Westhuizen. Well, Honeyball has made an immediate impact at fly half. He's got this Springbok backline moving forward. Admittedly, when the match is all over, but the Springboks kicking their chances away in this game here today.
Nice to see them keep the ball up. Everyone did their job and the support player came to it. Drotsky particularly good because he's in the open. He's been sent on to be the loose forward. It's done well.
Good. 17th try to Joost van der Westhuizen. Kick was successful, so 50 plays 28, 22 points the difference.
We were questioning the Springbok tactics of kicking the ball, and that time get the ball in hand, and the try was the outcome. Bull Allen makes his entrance to the field.
And the crowd erupts. And South Africa got a bonus point there for their fourth try. Bonus points awarded for four tries or more. James Small chasing well. Marshall there. James Small showing good tenacity, but Marshall too good. Got away from Drotsky. Numbers here. Irimia. Butts. Wilson. Bennett in front. Mertens. Irimia. Bull Allen supports. Cronfield goes in. Olo Brown and Wilson. Quick hands from Mertens. Tana Umanga lost a head. Referee plays on. Zinzan Brook. Well, it was lost a head earlier by Umanga, who didn't regather the ball. So the knock-on should have been awarded earlier on, but poetic justice there for the box.
Well, the Springboks side absolutely exhausted. The All Black waves continue to hit. This time Zinzan Brook. Ball dislodged close to the line.
Marshall really setting things up early in the fray with a big cutout pass and some great drawing of the defence and then moving the ball back into space. So the score remains at 50-28, and that's where the ball travelled ahead. Referee said it went backwards, and Zinzan just losing control right on the goal line. 5 metre scrum. All Blacks going for another pushover. Van der Westhuizen's had some treatment for an injury.
Be interesting to see how Bull Allen goes at loose head this side instead of Craig Dowd. He's fresh and he wants a go at Marius Herder.
Get your hand off the floor!
Finally, we've seen a referee penalise front rowers for putting their hand down on the ground.
Well, that's the only thing that could have saved them. 50 plays, 28. Here's Tana Umanga. Big tackle by Honeyball.
James Small just slipping around or side there, but the referees let it go.
Marshall and Cronfeld. Bull Allen on the 10-metre line. 22-point leads. Olo Brown into Andrews. Easy metres at the moment. And hitting the referee in the backside. New Zealand 50, South Africa 28. Thanks, man.
Hand off the floor.
37 metres out from the goal line. Zinzan Brook, incredible pass. Cullen, Umanga. Van der Westhuizen couldn't get him. Tana Umanga from the Wellington Hurricanes. His fifth test try. That is number 7 for the All Blacks.
Skillful work from Zinzan Brook, and likewise for Christian Cullen. Tana Umanga scored a truckload of tries for the Wellington Hurricanes, this time getting across the All Blacks.
Well, the tide has eventually turned in these All Black Springboks clashes. This is a comprehensive defeat of the Springboks.
South Africa with just the one match remaining now at Loftus-Versfeld against the Wallabies. That match in a fortnight. Tana Umanga, a very happy young man. Over 50 first-class tries. And the toast of Wellington. 100 kilograms, too much there for Van der Westhuizen.
Carlos Spencer off the field, but Andrew Merton's on, and this guy can really kick.
He's not a bad backup to run on, and I think John Hart, he doesn't often run on people like Mark Allen and Andrew Merton. He's very keen to get them in and give them opportunities for some playing time, and also to have a look at his kicking prowess.
So Merton's with his first shot at goal, a point-scoring record from Carlos Spencer of 25. New Zealand 57-28. So just a correction, that kick going outside the upright, score remaining at 55-28. 27-point advantage. Heaviest loss ever for South Africa in a test match, the highest score ever by New Zealand is Bennett. Jeremiah the tackler. Good effort there by Russell Bennett, the fullback. Back for Dalton. Tried very hard. Rousseau. Back to Van der Westhuizen. Just grubbering that up the touchline. No touch. Cronfeld. Marshall. Pass went forward. Sneyman. There's a gap. He's quick. Merton's there. Rousseau taken. Montgomery. Who wants it? Andrews arrives. Van Heerden is there. South Africa with their chance. Zinzendbrook has to let it come back. Has to be a try. Peter Rousseau. And the Springboks get their fifth. A late consolation.
Well, quite unbelievably. Five tries you score in a test match and lose by a margin such as this. You'd hardly think it was possible. They kept going at it, and Sneyman quite thoughtfully took it up himself and received the support. It was then great work that developed out wide, and they just had the numbers. Honeyball just held it up, such as his skill. Gave Peter Rousseau a try.
That looks like the final whistle. So the record books have been rewritten at Eden Park. The New Zealand All Blacks with a record score, the highest ever against the Springboks. 55 plays 35, 20-point margin, and a triumph for Sean Fitzpatrick, leading this New Zealand side for the 50th time in a test match, and Frank Butt celebrates his 50th test in style as well.
Well, what an entertainment out of this test match, Eden Park, Auckland, as we finish this game.
So the final score here, 55 plays 35. We'll be back after the break to wrap up. Yes, Christian Cullen getting the second of his two tries at Eden Park today. 55 plays 35, New Zealand's highest ever score against South Africa. The Springboks getting their highest ever score against New Zealand. They scored five tries and lost the game, Simon. Amazing stuff. 12 tries scored in Auckland.
Yes, Gordon, it's a strange sort of game. We said about the tight five getting into them. When they did in the second half, that was more New Zealand type of football, and losing a player, it really made the difference.
And the stats quite interesting, because the possession and territory were 50-50, yet the All Blacks used the ball so much better than the Springboks. And the Springboks tired with Fenter being sent off and really couldn't get out there and back up their numbers and keep the rampaging All Blacks at bay.
Okay, let's have a look at the Tri Nations table and the All Blacks. Well, Australia has to beat them at Dunedin next week to keep their hopes alive, but New Zealand getting bonus points, unbeaten in their three games. Let's hear from the winning skipper.
Well, every game against South Africa is tough, Sean, and I would imagine that you think this one was just as tough as the rest of them.
Well, definitely in the first half. They got into us a bit. It was a bit disappointing the first half because we wanted to go out and express ourselves, and it was a great day, and we haven't done it all year. But I was very pleased in the second half that we managed to dot down a few tries and show what we're capable of.
I think the crowd was delighted with this effort. So many tries, some brilliant play this afternoon.
It was, and we knew that in the second half we had to pick the pace up, and we saw them walking a bit in the first half. But in the first half, we were just doing enough to keep in front. And in the second half, the tight five got into the game, and Cully got going, and Uwa got involved, and had good fun. That's what we wanted to play today. We wanted to express ourselves and enjoy ourselves.
You were in the wars a wee bit today?
Well, I always are against South Africa, but it was a physical game, and I think they bring the best of us, you know, bring the best of us out, and just pleased to get it over and done with.
The crowd loved it.
Yeah, it was fantastic. I think, you know, all of New Zealand was right into it, and I'm sure, you know, the people at home watching on TV are as excited as the people are here.
Still a game to go, but you've already won the Tri Nations. You've got to lift that heavy cup again.
I don't know. I think Australia's still got a chance if they win next week, because I hope they won't. And then they've got an opportunity in Africa to square, I suppose.
Hey, great stuff, Sean. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Yes, I'm glad the slate was squared there. Australia still has a chance of winning the Tri Nations, and our live telecast from Dunedin next week. Check your local guides. That's going to be a cracker. Australia has never won there. And don't forget AFL Match of the Day. Hawthorn and West Coast today on the 7 Network. Please check your local guides. 55 plays, 35. A cracking win to New Zealand, but a very courageous performance by South Africa. We hope you enjoyed it. On behalf of Chris and Simon, that's all from 7 Sport.